हेलो स्टूडेंट, आई एम गोइंग टू टीच यू सब्जेक्ट फिजिक्स। योर फर्स्ट यूनिट इज इलेक्ट्रोस्टैटिक्स। इन इलेक्ट्रोस्टैटिक्स यू शुड हैव द नॉलेज ऑफ चार्ज। बेसिकली हाउ कैन चार्ज डेवलप इन एनी मटेरियल। अबाउट 2500 ईयर्स एगो ए फेमस यूनानी फिलासफर थेल्स ऑब्जर्व दैट द मटेरियल लाइक अम्बर व्हेन द मटेरियल लाइक अम्बर व्हेन रब्ड विद वूल इट गेन आर रिक्वायर्ड द प्रॉपर्टी दैट इट अट्रैक्ट्स टिनी ऑब्जेक्ट्स लाइक पेपर ऑफ पीसेस स्ट्रॉज एक्सेट्रा। आफ्टर दैट इन 1600 साइंटिस्ट गिलबर्ट डिस्कवर्ड दैट लाइक अम्बर सम आल्सो व्हेन बीइंग रब्ड इट आल्सो गेन द प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ अट्रैक्टिंग टिनी ऑब्जेक्ट। सो वी कैन से दैट चार्ज इज डेवलप इन एनी मटेरियल बाय रबिंग और बाय फ्रिक्शन। देयर आर टू टाइप ऑफ चार्जेज, वी नो पॉजिटिव एंड निगेटिव चार्जेज। क्वेश्चन इज राइज दैट हाउ पॉजिटिव एंड निगेटिव चार्जेज डेवलप इन एनी मटेरियल। When glass rod is rubbed with silk, the electron from glass rod migrate towards silk. Then there is efficiency in glass rod, so glass rod becomes positive. Efficiency in glass rod, so glass rod become positive and silk rod becomes negative. Similarly, when a bonite rod is rubbed with cat skin, here electrons from cat skin migrate toward a bonite rod, so there is excess of electron in a bonite rod, so this become negatively charged and cat skin becomes positively charged. Okay. So here we have two type of charges, positive and negative charges. And we have read already that there is a force between two charges. When the charges are like, then the force between two charges is repulsion force. They repel each other. And when the charges are unlike, then the force between two charges is force of attraction. In 1785, scientist Coulomb discovered a law by which we can calculate the force between two charges. This force is called electric force. According to Coulomb's law, when two point charges are stationary, or we can say, in other words, two stationary point charges are placed in air or vacuum, then the force of attraction and repulsion, between two charges is directly proportional to the product of two charges, and this force is also inversely proportional to the square of distance between them. Once again, when two stationary point charges are situated in air or vacuum, then force of attraction or repulsion either be proportional to the product of two charges and inversely proportional to the square of the distance between them. From above two equation we can write F is proportional to Q1 Q2 upon R square. Okay, F is equal to K Q1 Q2 upon R square, where small k is a proportionality constant and the value of k by experiment is 9 into 10 to the power 9 newton meter square per coulomb square. But the condition for this value is force is taken in newton, charge is taken in coulomb and direction and distance is taken in meter. Okay. For convenience, K is also written as 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught. A new word here, epsilon naught. This is the permittivity of free space. Epsilon naught is called permittivity of free space. And for the value of epsilon naught, value of epsilon naught from equation third we can get F is equal to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught U1 U2 upon R square. This is the formula to determine the force between two charges. From here, epsilon 0 is equal to Q1 Q2 upon F 4 pi R square. When Q1 and Q2 is equal to 1 coulomb, F is equal to 9 into 10 to the power 9 newton, R is equal to 1 meter, then the value of epsilon naught is equal to 8 into 8.85 10 to the power minus 12 coulomb square per newton meter square. And the unit of epsilon naught from above formula coulomb square per newton meter square. Okay.